for most of human history. The fetus has been really shrouded in mystery and multiple layers of the maternal abdomen obscuring anything that was wrong with the fetus.
With the emergence of prenatal diagnostic techniques, particularly with the advent of maternal fetal ultrasound, we could view into the womb for the first time.
We could see things we'd never seen before. And as those fetuses were followed, it became more clear what may or may not happen to them.
There were a certain category of birth defects that were, for the most part, lethal, where when the baby was born, we were too late to do anything about it.
That was really the impetus to try to knock on the door sooner.
Perhaps we can treat this new group of highly selected unborn patients who have severe diseases that are progressive during the pregnancy. Maybe we could treat them before birth, and that was a very radical and controversial concept.
At 20 weeks, I had the level 2 ultrasound, and everything was fine. About 5 weeks later, I went for a regular checkup with my OB, and he said, you know, you're measuring a couple weeks ahead of schedule. Let's just get an ultrasound and just make sure everything's going okay. And that's when we found out that I was carrying a very, very sick baby.
I think about fetal surgery work being presented at national, international meetings, and essentially being laughed out of the room.
Most people thought we were crazy because there had to be at least 100 reasons why you couldn't operate on a fetus.
There was also a lot of skepticism about whether or not this was really beneficial.
That's frequently the case with something that's new. And it was our obligation to not only convince the world, convince ourselves, but all that work had to be done prior to starting it clinically.
We had to know that if we offered anything before birth, it had to be safe for mom.
We had to go into the experimental laboratory and work principally with fetal sheep to develop the animal models and the techniques that we hoped someday could be used clinically.
We showed that those anatomic abnormalities caused the same sort of organ damage that was seen in human fetuses, and we showed in the animal model again that it could be corrected before birth.
Then we had to apply this cautiously in the clinical realm, isolated cases, being brutally honest with the families about what we could and could not do, what our hopes were and what our fears were.
And people began to believe, oh, in certain select instances, it's not crazy to operate on the baby before they're born.
When they told us what fetal surgery meant, it was very surreal. It was something out of a sci-fi movie.
We sat down with the doctors and they gave us their conclusions on what they believed Addison's condition was, that she had a mediastinal teratoma, which is a large tumor in her chest that had compacted her heart and her lungs.
So she actually was in heart failure. We were told it was a 50-50 chance of survival through the surgery. And we felt that was enough to proceed.
We spent a lot of time talking about the risks and the benefits and the fact that we have failures as well as successes.
They couldn't have been more professional and caring and making us feel like we were making the right decision. And no matter what decision we made, they would have been fully supportive of.
The Center for Fetal Diagnosis and Treatment at CHOP is one of a handful of centers throughout the United States and, in fact, the world, and undoubtedly the largest.
CHOP was really the ideal place to develop a center.
CHOP is an unbelievable place. So there's layers and layers of expertise.
What we know and are able to tell families because we've lived it is an amazing resource for families. And with the opening of the Garbose Family Special Delivery Unit, we have continually improved the outcome of mother and baby.
The SDU at CHOP is the first of its kind, where you deliver the fetus in a children's hospital where all of the services that fetus needs are immediately available.
Dr. Adzik described some of the early procedures to us and how it had changed, and just from where he was and where he had come to when he operated on Addison was an amazing change and an amazing improvement, and I expect it to continue.
babies are still dying. We don't understand enough. But our lab here is entirely focused on learning everything we possibly can about the mysteries of the fetus.
There's incredible research endeavor that is always knocking on the next door.
From maternal safety, imaging techniques, to open fetal surgery, to now minimally invasive fetal surgery, and ultimately to stem cell and gene therapy.
In the next 5 years, we'll be treating a child with sickle cell disease in utero with a single injection of cells.
We're gonna see kids who had diagnoses that there was no hope for. We're gonna see these kids actually surviving and living great lives because of these interventions that they're doing and because of the research that they're doing.
We see teenagers now when before we saw fetuses. And that work would not have been possible without the support from donors.
Philanthropy is an opportunity to have tremendous impact.
And what better thing to fund than babies? I mean, because you're funding a cure for a lifetime.
Truly, they're saving lives and making families whole and happy.
The ultimate payoff is seeing a mom come back with her child and how normal they are and how active they are and how smart they are.
Addison is everything a three-year-old little girl should be. She is nosy, she doesn't listen, she smiles, she's happy, she likes wearing her dresses.
Addison is a delight. People say to me, she's so happy, and she has just got such a bright love of life.
And you watch her grow, and you watch her smile, and you watch how she changes and how she's conquered the obstacles in her way, and you're amazed.
When she was born and so sick, I never would have imagined that she would be doing as well as she is today. And if the Center for Fetal Diagnosis and Treatment was not there, or if we were not made aware of it, Addison would not be here today.
People that know her, they look at her and they can't believe it. And all you can do is you sit there and you say, just look at her now.
Look at me now. Look at me now. Hello.
Say, look at me now.
Hello.
Say hooray.
Yay. Look at me now. Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now. Look at me now. Look at me now. See me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Look at me now.
Say bye.
Bye.